So hello, today our topic is presentation layer, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. And dear all, please subscribe and also please share to your friends. So presentation layer is the second topmost layer of the OSI model. If I talk about the presentation layer, so this layer is responsible for the translation of data in between the application layer as well as the network. So basically, this layer ensures that the data sent by the application layer of one system can be readable by the application layer of the another system. So there are three main tasks performed by this layer: data compression, data encryption, and data translation. Basically, these three tasks performed by this layer. Okay. Now, if I talk about these three tasks, so these three tasks have their specific work. If I talk about the data translation, the meaning of translation is that the conversion of data from one language or from one code to the another type of code. Basically, the data encryption convert the data from application layer into the format that can be transmitted over the network, like your network can understand the another language, like binary language. So that can be done by the help of data translation. Let us example that it can convert a text file into the ASCII format or a standard format like JPG or PNG. So it also ensures that the data is universally understandable format on both sides. Like we have an image, so you already know that if you are using any computer, like or tablet or any mobile phone, so all of these can understand the image into these two format, either JPG or PNG. So that is what done by the data translation, that a format that is fully understandable by any of the device in the world. For the data translation, so this is my source that is using ASCII format, okay, and this is my destination which is using EBC DIC format, that is also called binary format. So the data translation will convert this ASCII format to EBC DIC, or EBC DIC to ASCII conversion will be done by the presentation layer, and in presentation layer that is done by the data translation. Now let us take one more example. Like this is an example also. If I have an image, like which is any format, and if I want to open this image into a device, so we have to convert this into a specific format like JPG or PNG types of images, like WebP or any type of image can be possible that can be readable by your network. Basically, we have seen JPEG or PNG generally over the networks. Okay. Now, if I talk about the data compression, so how the data compression works? So, what is the meaning of compression? Basically, the meaning of compression is what? The reduction of size. So, in the data compression technique, we reduce the size to send the data over the networks. So the data compression technique of presentation layer reduces the size to send over the network, and it is specially work over the multimedia files. Like you already know that audio files and video files have a very large size. In that case, we do the reduction of size. Now, this is an example of data compression and decompression. Here on this end, this is a sender, and this is a file of 20 MB that will be forwarded through the network. This file will be forwarded to the internet first. On when it will be forwarded to the internet, data compression will be done. The file of 20 MB will be converted into 2.5 of MB. Then the data will be forwarded to the receiving end when the size will be 2.5 MB. Then when it will be received by the system, so the decompression will be done by the presentation layer. Okay, so this task is called compression and decompression of the file, and that is done over the presentation layer. Now let's discuss about the next one, which one is that? Data encryption. Basically, in data encryption or decryption, we use to change the format of the file that cannot be understood by any hack. The data encryption technique ensures that the data security by encrypting the data before transmission and decrypting it upon the reception. That is means encrypt the data, also decrypt the data on the reception. and common protocols and methods used are SSL or TLS. Here, SSL is used over the website. So this provides the encryption technique as well as the certificates over the network, over the website, so that your website will forward the encrypted format or secure format of data. That is called AES encryption technique. Okay. So this is how the encryption and decryption of the file done. Okay. This is your data file. Whenever the file will be forwarded to the internet, before forwarding to the internet, the encryption will be done. The format will be changed. Okay. Then over the internet, we will forward the encrypted file, in which we will also add the key. Okay. And on the receiving end, decryption of file will be done. And that is done by the help of what? The presentation layer. So this is what the third task performed by the presentation layer. Okay. And for now, we will do some practical regarding that. So I will tell you how to do the encryption and how to do the compression of the file and how the SSL certificate works. Now, let's talk about the SSL certificate. So SSL certificate provides the encryption to a web page, basically. So let me open the google.com. So this is the google.com web page, and in this, just click on this icon. Okay. Whenever you will click on this icon, a pop-up will be open. Here you will find the connection is secure. That is means that your SSL certificate is working. What? Your SSL certificate is working, and whenever you will click here, it will show you that the certificate is valid. And whenever you will click this certificate, you will find that the Google is using SHA 256 fingerprints, in which this is your public key and there's a private key that cannot be seen here. Okay. So this is how the Google does the encryption on its website, on its web page. Okay. Now let me also give you a tutorial that how you can encrypt your data, how you can also encrypt your any file. Okay. So this is a website in which you can convert plain text into SHA 256 encryption. So SHA 256 is also a type of encryption. Let me copy some text. Okay. Whenever I will paste this text, so this is three lines of text approximately. So this will be converted into a single line of text. So this is called SHA 256 conversion, basically. And you can also do the encryption by this website. And you can also do the decryption for the same. Okay. So that is all about the presentation layer. So dear all, please subscribe my channel. And thanks a lot for watching this.